Welcome,
am I?
Our coven's resources and weaponry are yours to transform these raw recruits into death dealers worthy of your name. Varga will be your right-hand man. He knows all our strengths and weaknesses. He is also our most prolific lichen killer with over 40 confirmed kills.
Tamama.
David, welcome.
Thank you.
To mark the safe arrival of our guests, I've arranged a little soiree in the winter garden.
That's really lovely. Thank you.
Nonsense. Soon there's a need to indulge in pleasure. In terms of war, this coven needs moments to celebrate. The arrival of Thomas, David, and Celine is reason aplenty to rejoice. To us all.
What's going on, ladies and gentlemen? Cyberland coming back to you with another film review, and this time we're moving on to, at least for now, the last of the Underworld films. Underworld Blood Wars. So, after I was watching the fourth film, Awakening, I went straight into this one, and time frame, I think, is not too... Wait, no, let me see. It didn't feel like too long, yeah. It doesn't really kind of give the time frame. However, with this film, it's just pretty much, I guess, after Awakening, the Vampire Covenant realized that Selena's still alive. I guess they thought she was dead. And they want vengeance because of what happened with Victor, even though they don't know the full story of the situation with Victor. So with this film, because of what's happened with Awakening, lichens are still reproducing at a quick speed as opposed to vampires, not so much, that there's only one covenant left. Most of the vampires have been decimated from what happened with Four and Or being killed by lichens. So because Celine is pretty much the last of the death dealers, most of them have been annihilated, they want her to train a new set of death dealers, among other things. Of course, Celine at this point, because her daughter, she hasn't been able to find her, she's not really interested in getting involved anymore with other vampires. She's really just trying to be left alone and just search for her daughter to some extent. But she realizes that, to some degree, she still kind of cares about those who have helped her in regards to Awakening and such. That's one way to spin it. As far as, you know, out of all the Underworld films, I felt this one was the most political. There was a lot of backstabbing and shenanigans of that sort, as opposed to the other films. It was a lot of who's behind the curtain or who's controlling what. It was still entertaining. I give it a 4 out of 5, yes, sirs. I liked it as much as Awakening, but still. And, of course, better than Rise of the Lycans, but not better than 1 and 2. I felt 1 and 2 is like a two-part story, and I felt Awakening and Blood Wars is a two-part story. Yeah. Character-wise, again, and that's his name. Charles Dance, that's the gentleman from Awakening that really I enjoyed. I loved his screen time on here, too. He was great. And you get to see him get down, too. That was cool. And then you still have characters from the fourth film that are in here that are, just as good. Also, a lot of backstory gets opened up, too, for certain characters that I thought was really interesting. I didn't see them coming from that angle with certain characters outside of school. Action wise, I think this film had more action, but it's the normal action you expect from the Underworld films. The other thing is that there's not really any city in here aside from maybe two scenes. It's more so the Vampire Covenant, and kind of going off into the mountains. It was kind of gave off a vibe of like monks kind of thing, shrines or forget that term. And this is my ignorance, where monks tend to be. It kind of gave off that element, like that's how some of the vampires were being kind of thing. Villain wise is again gray area. The villain in here, was a step down from the other villains. However, this villain still was crafty and a good fighter and very cunning and ruthless, which they hadn't shown. Well, I hadn't seen that since Victor. I would say that. Yeah. I would say I hadn't seen that ruthlessness and cunningness. But Victor wasn't sneaky. This villain was. So, I don't advise you to watch this film if you haven't seen the other films. There's too much in here that they already state that. You'd be like, huh? What? So watch them in order, or, at least watch the first two. And you don't have to watch Rise of the Lycans to watch this film, but I would advise, if you're going to watch this, you should have already seen 1 and 2 and Awakening if you're going to watch this film. So with that being said, yeah, entertaining, action, shooting, the normal Underworld stop. Hopefully, I know the last time this was talked about for a sixth film that Kate Beckinsale said she was done. But I really feel like this film didn't conclude everything. I think there needs to be one more film and then shut it down. Like with her character. Not necessarily kill her off, but come full circle with the character. I feel they still haven't done that just yet. I think there's some loose there's some elements that haven't been fully done yet. So we'll see. I mean, they could leave it where it's at and it'd be fine, but I just kind of hope there's just some other things that they should do to close everything up. Yeah. So with that being said, I will catch you guys on the next one. Take care.